at night, LeBron now has a voodoo doll of opposing players, and he has to stick them in order for them not to play so he can make the playoffs.
Tonight, big game at the Staples Center. Every game now is big for the Los Angeles Lakers and the Milwaukee Bucks.
There we go.
Owner of the best record in the NBA.
There we go for tonight. We got it.
Owner of the best record in the NBA visits the Staples Center, and Giannis Antetokounmpo. Are you listening to anything I'm saying?
Yes, you said a big game, Staples Center.
The front runner for the MVP award, the heir apparent to the mythical title of world's best player, is visiting the Staples Center tonight, and he is going to be matched up with one LeBron James. And Rob Parker, I got to say something.
I'm throwing
something.
Up the L.
I got to say something. Of course
Loser.
You are. I got to say something.
Say it.
That you're not going to like. But the stars, I mean the ones in the sky, I don't mean celebrities, are aligning for the Lakers. And here's why I say that.
I want you to make your case, and then I'm going to shoot it down.
Golden State starting to struggle, and I don't think they're not going to win it.
Comical.
Don't get me wrong.
Comical.
But they might not be the first seed.
Comical.
The Lakers' chances of getting to the seventh seed are really slim. And now that Golden State looks like they might not be the first seed, if the Lakers just get the eighth seed, they would meet the inexperienced Denver Nuggets in the first round. And I tell you what, I'm taking LeBron over Jokic in that one. Secondly, Marvin Bagley, this is sad, but it is a benefit for the Lakers. Marvin Bagley, who's been playing some very, very good basketball for the upstart Sacramento Kings, is injured. That's one of the teams the Lakers have to leapfrog. They're one game ahead of Los Angeles. So you've got that.
Are they in the eighth seed?
They're ninth.
Oh, okay.
The Lakers just had a game the other night against the New Orleans Pelicans, and Anthony Davis only played 21 minutes. That was a blessing to the Lakers. And tonight, Giannis, arguably the best player in the world right now, going to be the MVP most likely. He sat out two games ago, was on a minutes restriction in their last game, and maybe on a minutes restriction tonight.
Is he or isn't he?
We don't know.
Oh, okay.
But just the fact that there's a question is a blessing for the Lakers. So my point is,
and it'll all be moved when they lose tonight.
Things are falling into place. Now they have to capitalize. I'm not saying it's going to be easy. It's the biggest stretch I've ever heard. What do you think I'm saying? That they definitely getting in the playoffs?
Yeah.
What I'm saying is these are things that are falling in their favor. That's all I'm saying. Are you going to tell me they're not?
The Warriors are half a game out of first place. What are they, a game out?
In first right now.
The Warriors?
They're half a game ahead of Denver.
Okay, so they're half a game ahead of Denver.
But they lost four of their last six.
I get that. I know that they lost.
All I'm saying, Rob, is these things are all falling in their favor. That's it. And I think that's undeniable.
This is where we are with LeBron James, the greatest player on the planet, is that we need eight different moving parts to work for him to make the playoffs. To be the eighth seed in the playoffs in the NBA when half the league makes the playoffs.
Don't forget he missed 18 games.
I don't care about those games.
Don't forget Rondo missed 34.
He's back now. He's back now, and they've won six of their last 16 or six of their last 10.
You don't even know.
15. Six of their last 15.
Don't spit it out unless you know.
No, I'm just saying this is so ridiculous that, wait a minute, LeBron has to have nine things happen and somebody's leg has to fall off for LeBron to make the playoffs, and you're talking about like, winning against Milwaukee is a layup because Giannis might play.
Did I say it was a layup?
Because Giannis might play 30 minutes and not 40 minutes. All I mean is, first of all, it's not even Sacramento who's in the eighth spot right now. It's the Clippers, and they're not one game ahead of the Lakers. There are a few spots ahead.
The Clippers traded away their best player.
Nice, and the Clippers keep winning. You know what?
Really? They just lost their last game.
They're not buying into the tanking.
They're under 500 for like the last two.
That's fine. How many games ahead are they of the Lakers?
Three.
All right, very nice. And they play the Lakers coming up as well.
That's another. I didn't even mention that.
Those are the two wins that they're going to have.
If LeBron, and you're right, he's got to go get it done.
We've seen the fact that they play the Clippers twice is huge for them. The idea that they're coming off of losses to Memphis and New Orleans.
They're not coming off a loss. They're coming off a win.
I'm talking about the last few games. Their last three losses were against. Their last three game losses were against Cleveland. I'm talking about their last three losses were against Atlanta, New Orleans, and Memphis. And then the game that they did win at home against New Orleans, they needed Anthony Davis not to play the fourth quarter in order for them to squeak out a 5-point
win. You're making my argument.
That's all they were there to squeak out a win against that team.
It was a blessing to them. That's what I'm saying. Things are falling in place.
I'm not buying all that.
LeBron has to capitalize. The Lakers have to capitalize. But don't tell me they don't have things lined up. I mean, they're lining up
for them. Give me their next five games. Their next five games are tough games.
It doesn't matter
who they
play.
Four of the five games are against playoff teams. This is a bad team.
Two of their last three wins have been against playoff teams. They've been against contenders.
The last five games of the season are all against teams in the playoffs as well.
What matters for the Lakers is that how they are, where they're at mentally. We've seen them lose, as you said, to these horrible teams. And then they go out and beat Boston. They beat Houston.
On a lucky shot.
Whatever, Rob. It doesn't matter. No, you're not just saying.
When was the last time they played a good game and beat a good team? Christmas? Are we going to go back
when
to the Warriors?
When they beat a good team? How about Houston? No. How about you, James Harden, the best player on the planet? How about that?
Houston didn't have a free throw for 20 minutes straight to end the game. Unheard of in NBA history.
Who won the game?
That's the kind of luck that they need to win a game?
Who won the game?
Stop it, Chris. You know better.
No. How are you taking that game from them?
I'm not. I'm giving it to them, but I'm just telling you.
Then that's your last game over a good team?
No, their last good win over a good team was the Warriors on Christmas Day.
Why wasn't the Houston win a good one?
I just told you.
Why wasn't the Boston win a good one?
Because Rondo never hit a game-winning shot. That's his first game-winning shot in his 15-year NBA career. Lucky.
I don't care if it was luck. I don't care
if Boston didn't show up and they lost by forfeit.
The Lakers won the game. That's all I'm saying. There's not all this nuance and these vagaries that you're throwing out. Oh, they didn't really win because he got a lucky shot. No.
You shouldn't be talking about LeBron that he needs luck in order to win. Oh, he needs the stars to be aligned. He's got to see us.
At night,
LeBron now has a voodoo doll of opposing players. And he has to stick them in order for them not to play so he can make the playoffs. How enticing is that? How great is that in NBA history? The LeBron James voodoo doll. That's what he needs to make the playoffs.
I don't know about all that.
You're from New Orleans.
I don't know about that.
I think you have one on me because some nights I don't feel good. Well, you know, when I kill you in debates all day on the radio show,
and then
I get home and I'm like in pain.
Sick. Yeah, all right.
Right? You know you have a voodoo doll. It's probably in your bag.
That's against my religion.
Let me check your bag.
I don't do that stuff.
You from that town.
I know, but not me. All right, it's your turn to weigh in. Are the stars aligning for one LeBron James and the Lakers? And will they be able to capitalize? That's the most important thing. Whether you think they're aligning or not, will the Lakers be able to capitalize and get in the playoffs and maybe, just maybe, get Denver in the first round? It's your turn to weigh in, 877-99. 99-